Now, if you own or are planning to own a high-performance Nikon or Canon or Panasonic camera, one that's a hybrid that shoots both video and stills very well, I've a suggestion for you to get the best performance from your camera. At the end of this video, I'll also share with you some performance data from some tests I undertook using the Nikon Z9, shooting RAW at 20 frames per second, and it's quite impressive. Now, have you heard of a memory card manufacturer called Angelbird? They're based in Austria. That's Austrian Europe, not Australia. Now, it's a small company that's been launching some really cool products, and you should definitely check them out. My name's Alnoor, Meralli, and I'm a fashion, portrait, and event photographer. Let's jump right in. If your camera has dual memory card slots, it's often suggested that you use matching memory cards. Now, this may have its use case where the same image file is being written to both cards. But if not, then why not customize the memory card slots for the media you're shooting? Fast memory for high-speed stills and large memory with hours of capacity for video. So where does Angelbird come in? A couple of months ago, Angelbird released two new memory cards with exactly this application. Now, when I received my Nikon Z9 in January, yes, I was lucky, I'd made the decision to purchase the pair. I had little idea at that time just how well these cards would perform compared with other CFexpress Type B cards in the market. A call out here to Matt Granger, who tested an extensive range of cards with the Z9. The Angelbird card for video recording supports 8K RAW, and it's called the AV Pro SE. It's appropriately sized at 0.5 terabyte with a sustained write speed of 800 megabytes. You heard me right. Angelbird publishes not only the maximum speed, but also their sustained speed. But what about performance to handle 20 frames per second or even 30 frames per second raw image file captures? Now that's where their second card comes in, the AV Pro SX. Now, since it's designed for still image captures, it needs to be faster rather than massive. Angelbird publishes its sustained speed at 1480 megabytes per second. Now, that sounds compelling. So how does it perform in practice? I tested the SX card on the Nikon Z9 shooting at 20 frames per second RAW. Now, Nikon offers multiple RAW formats. My first test was the most challenging. Using lossless compressed RAW file sizes of 56 megabytes, I was able to write 75 consecutive frames with zero delay. The more practical RAW format for me is really the high efficiency STAR, which is a virtually lossless format, a typical file size of 32 megabytes. This is what was impressive. I was able to capture 586 consecutive shots with zero delay. Now that's shy of having the shutter release down for 30 seconds. Subsequent frames were also captured, but were late by about 1/100th of a second. That's more performance than I will ever need. But what about size? It's 160 gigabytes. Now that gets me over 5,000 RAW captures on a single card. The camera settings, by the way, were AFC wide area focus and I wasn't doing the camera or the memory card any favors. I was using an early generation adapted 24 to 70 millimeter 2.8 f-mount lens. So what about price for all this performance? Both the SC and the SX cards are selling at exactly the same price, $179. Going back to my proposition of using media-specific cards, let me know below where you stand. Would you customize one slot for stills and the other for video? If you found this video useful, please like and subscribe and support this new channel. See you soon.